start the meeting. Can I welcome everybody to this meeting of Cabinet. I just need to ask for Phil Brightmore's apologies to be recorded. He's not able to be here this morning. So we'll go straight into item one, which is members' code of conduct. Do any members wish to declare any interests? No? Okay, thank you. Item two are the minutes of the last meeting. Can we agree that I sign them as a true record? Is that correct? Thank you. Thanks very much. Okay, I'm just going to just slightly amend the agenda in the sense that we are going to defer item six, residence parking scrutiny review. Okay, so that item is deferred. So that takes us then to item three, which is executive key decisions, of which there are none. So we then go to the first substantive report, which is item four. The snappily titled National Non-Domestic Rates Discretionary Relief 2017-2018 is supporting businesses in Wirral. Okay, and I'm going to ask Janette to introduce this, please.
Thanks, Phil. I'm glad you said it,
because
I wanted to say that. Okay, so I think this is a good news story, and I'm pleased to present this report. Business rates, business rate evaluation took place in 2017 this year, which saw many businesses see a steep increase in their rateable value, which would mean that they were paying substantially more for the same property that they might have been in previous. So this has also coincided with the change in government policy, which now means that local authorities will retain 100% of their business rates, which makes it critical that Wirral encourages new and existing businesses to grow and stay on Wirral, as well as vital that we have a robust approach to business rates collection and recovery. So in order to assist the businesses affected by the increases in business rates, the government's announced three government-sponsored initiatives, which we've incorporated into our amended National Non-Domestic Rates Discretion Relief Policy. They are support for small businesses, the discretion fund, and support for houses. The first one, supporting small businesses. So this is for businesses that are qualified under the criteria set down. The business rate increase will be limited to no more than £600 per annum, and we estimate around 30 businesses will qualify for that on Wirral. The second one stream is the discretionary fund. Now, this is money that governments have given us. They've set it aside and allocated it to local authorities to help with the impact of the business rates revaluation. Wirral's share is just over £910,000 over 4 years. First year, we help all businesses who fit the criteria as detailed in 3.9. We've also reduced the threshold for support from 12.5% increase in business rates to 5%, which means that we've actually lowered the we've increased the number of businesses that we can help by lowering the threshold for assistance. We're able to help 60 small businesses. 607 small to medium businesses, which is really good news. The third initiative is support for public houses with a rateable value of £100,000 or less. Paragraph 311 sets out the government policy intention of how pubs will be described under this and who will qualify for this help. And we will be helping funding pubs. Wirral has made the process as simple as possible for all businesses that qualify for this relief. There's no application forms to complete. We've identified eligible businesses and we'll be contacting them in due course, and we'll work as quickly as we can to update our software. So in essence, no business on Wirral who've been subject to an increase in their business rates will actually have to pay anything, or will have to pay over and above what they need to pay to Wirral after we've factored in relief. So work as quickly as we can to get our software updated, and we'll be in contact with everyone soon. So what I'd like to ask Cabinet to do is to agree the recommendations as laid out on page 2 of this report, which are that the National Non-Domestic Rates Discretionary Relief Policy be amended to incorporate the changes. You'll find that on page 7 to 11. that national model domestic rates discretionary relief policy is detailed to be approved for 2017-18.
Okay, thanks, Janette. I mean, I think this is a very positive report. I mean, I like probably many people, would take aback at some of the increases that lots of businesses, not just in rural actually, but up and down the country had to pay as a result of the government's business rates revaluation. And, you know, clearly something went wrong with that, and you know, we're now left with trying to, you know, pick up pieces really, if you like, with the revaluation exercise. But it's good that we've got, you know, 900,000 over 4 years, and I'm pleased that we're able to help, you know, 600 of our small businesses and 100 of our public houses. I mean, these are small businesses that often are surviving literally on the margin on a daily basis. So this additional, you know, money that will come back to them, I think, will be really welcome and might actually make a difference between some of these small businesses surviving and going under. So I think, you know, it's very, very welcome. Very, very much in line with our camp pledges about supporting small businesses. And I think it's something that you know, we should celebrate really. I'm very happy to endorse, you know, Jeanette's recommendations on page 2. Does anybody want to add anything else to that? So can we agree those recommendations? Thanks very much. Thanks, Jeanette. Okay, that takes us on then to item 5, which is making Wirral's community safe, the Safer Wirral Hub. And George, you'll introduce this, please.
Thanks, Rob. Thanks for the opportunity of bringing this to mind. I think it's an excellent report for everyone's in further detail. But I've got a few comments that I want to make at the end. So basically, I'm saying in the first instance that I was delighted to present the final Safer Wirral Hub's full business case. Reducing crime and antisocial behaviour, making sure Wirral's residents feel safe and are safe, could not be more important. Our residents have told us repeatedly that this should be among our top priorities, and I am delighted and proud that we have been able to create such an innovative and potentially powerful new approach. For many years, we have worked in close partnership with our colleagues at Merseyside Police and Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service, working together to prosecute offenders, to tackle problem areas and issues, and doing all we can to make our community safer places to live and visit. Last year, we launched the Wirral Plan, and two of its 20 pledges laid out ambitious 5-year strategies to tackle domestic violence and to ensure our neighbourhoods are safe. Now we are going much further and creating a fully integrated police and community safety service, the Safer Wirral Hub, the first of its kind in our region. Our new combined unit will allow for more visible presence in communities, more joined up approaches of tackling issues such as domestic violence, antisocial behaviour, and neighbourhood nuisance. I believe this is a hugely important step. It will help make Wirral safer, it will help tackle the issues our residents tell us are a problem, and even in times of continuing austerity and cuts to resources, it is imaginative and radical plan to deliver a better service to our residents. The hub will be based at the solar campus in Wallasey, and its official opening will take place on Tuesday, the 10th of October. I just want to say a couple of things in essence following that, because over the 6 weeks, summer holidays in particular, antisocial behaviour, a lot of people were saying and saying that it hasn't risen, and antisocial behaviour is falling and falling and falling. My perception, and I presume the perception of the people of Wirral, when they come to do the morning poll again, will still indicate that antisocial behaviour is very high on their agendas. What has happened is, and I think it's important we understand these things, Because since 2010, and the government's pledge of their own is to reduce the number of serving police officers, 2,500 police officers have gone from Merseyside. Now, no matter what anyone does or tells you any difference, you can't perform the same way as you did with less police. So to do this first of all, in the first place, is right. That's the correct way, in my opinion. Pool resources, make sure that we do our very best for the people who are willing to make sure that they remain safe. But I don't think we can just sit here and do nothing. I think it's very, very important, and I did this at a meeting last Wednesday with Mark Campbell and myself, with Ian Hassel. And we spoke with Ian Hassel for over an hour and a quarter about all the different problems that we foresaw in Wirral. He's now guaranteeing that from that meeting, that we will have that meeting every month, once a month, to ensure that we get feedback from him and we feed into him. There's a lot of things going on at the moment, and one thing I would actually plead, I suppose, is that the police at this present moment in time are in crisis. There's no other word for it. There's a meeting taking place this week, the Apple conference, and I listened to someone on television this morning before I came out, and they are calling for the government to release more resources and put more police officers back on the line of duty. I think it's absolutely imperative that we support that point of view, and therefore I would suggest that given hopefully the support of cabinet, that I myself or the leader of the council write to Jane Kennedy and the Chief Constable to give him our, or give them our fears of what is happening on the world at this present moment, right? And ask them to give the full support to this conference that's taking place and support our view that we definitely need more resources on the world to enable us to enact this properly. But as I just said before, the most important point to me is police are going through the same austerity as what we are going through here. And we're now, as you all know, down to two police stations, one in Wallasey and one in Brighton. And that is a sign of where we are today. So I just hope that I can get full support for what I've just proposed for I think the actual law, the business plan, is absolutely first class. But we shouldn't happen to be doing these sort of things if we were in not in austerity ways. So 10 years of austerity is not good. Thank you for that.
Okay, thanks, George. Anybody want to add anything to that? I'll say a few words in a second. Bernie.
Okay, George, I welcome this report. I know you've got to move forward, and this is a good way, you say, pooling all resources to move forward to tackle not just antisocial behaviour, but you know, outlines of this domestic violence and all the other things that come under the heading of this report. You're right, we've got a problem here and now as well, and I welcome the fact that we're going to be sitting down with Ian Hassel monthly to discuss this. But I think the public needs reassurance that we are taking this seriously and that we are going to do things, because the antisocial behaviour that we're describing now is not antisocial behaviour, it's criminality. So young people are committing criminal acts. And because we haven't got enough police to deal with that, the situation now is literally getting out of hand. And we have to say that Janette and myself have said it a couple of times over the weekend, and Janette quite rightly said enough is enough, and that's where we have to be at. We have to say to the police, something has to be done in the areas like Seacombe and Cllr where antisocial behaviour is past antisocial behaviour. It's criminal now, and we've got to do something for the public. This report is going to be, it's fabulous, and it's going to stand us in really good stead as we go forward. And I think we'll see some really positive things from this. But we also have to work with the police to do something about what's happening now. I welcome the fact that there was going to be writing to Jane and the chiefs, but I would welcome that. But we have to write to the government as well. The government have got to know that they've got to do something that it's, as I say, enough is enough. So I welcome the report, I'll be happily supporting it and doing whatever else we can. And my portfolio will be involved in an awful lot of that, because I think early intervention, as you say, is the answer. Not to all of it, but early intervention will be a project. So I welcome it and I'll work hand in hand with whatever I can.
Anyone else? Okay. So, oh, sorry, Stuart. Stuart, I recognise the issue that you highlighted with scrambler bikes. It's a particular issue in my ward that you know, residents are quite rightly saying our lives are being made hell. And I don't blame the police, because they are, as George, you quite rightly said, their resources have been absolutely decimated by the government over the last 7 years. And you know, it's really at breaking point. So I think it's quite right, as well as commending this new model of integrated working as the way forward in the future, I write to the Jane Kennedy, the Police and Crime Commissioner, and the Chief Constable, asking them to make urgent representations to governments to secure additional resources for police in Wirral, because we desperately need, and our communities desperately need, that extra or that proper support or protection. And I do hope that the ACPO conference, and I'm sure they will this week, George, will send that same message.
Absolutely.
And I think we would echo those sentiments. So George's moved recommendations on page 14, that we approve the Safer Rural Hub for Business case. The plan go live date, new model, 1st of October.
10th.
Oh, so 10th of October, isn't it? Right, not 1st of October, okay. And instruct officers from the strategic area to investigate further opportunities to develop a new model under the next phase of the project and report back. And then thirdly, I as leader write to Police and Crime Commissioner, Chief Constable, asking them to make urgent representations to the government to secure additional resources for policing in the world. Okay, so is that seconded?
Seconded.
Yeah, is that agreed?
Agreed.
That's agreed, okay, thanks very much. Right, we've deferred item six, so there is no other business that's been brought to my attention, so I'll close the meeting and thank you for your attendance. Thank you.